Good evening, participants. So we are starting with the web session. My name is Karan Vyas. I'll be moderating for this web session. And first of all, I'll make you familiar with the platform. So at the bottom left, you can see a mute button, which will be mute throughout the session. And if you want to raise your query, you can raise your query at the chat box. And so today's topic is e-commerce marketing, and we have an industry expert with us, Mr. Kamlesh. So I would request Kamlesh to take it forward from here. Kamlesh?
And share screen. Okay. Can you adjust to what? Hello guys. Hello. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay, shall we start?
Yes.
Continue with your session now.
Yeah, can all hear me?
Yes, they will communicate with you via chat box.
Okay. Cool.
Sure.
Cool. So this is Kamlesh Sawal, and today I'll be taking you through one to two case studies of e-commerce, and I will be showing you the backend of Google Analytics and how the e-commerce companies can multiply the revenue, or how can they study the revenue and then it can optimize. We will see through that. So if any questions keep popping me a chat, and I'll try to address as many as possible. Sounds good? I'm assuming that is yes.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Cool. So, okay. So first case study, we're going to look at Suhani Pitti. That is a e-commerce portal where they're selling the jewelries. I'll just open the website as well. So I'm going to show you the front end of Suhani Pitti, and then I'm going to show you the back end of Google Analytics. How many of you have seen the Google Analytics before? How many of you? Can you hear me now? Okay, now someone is saying ki I am not audible, that's what I'm like saying. Okay, how many of you seen the Google Analytics? We can see this. Okay, uh, Okay, some of you saying I'm audible, some of you saying I'm not audible. So that's okay. Cool. So I'll just continue. So this is the website, sohanipetty.com, where they're trying to sell. So Sohanipetty is a renowned fashion designer, and she has her own collection, and she's selling those customized jewelry via this web page, and where you can see she has earrings, necklace, studs, celebrity closet for men, and then she has a bestseller, and she has various products to offer to her fans, followers, to the industry people. So we're gonna look at. So when you look at the website, I think it's visible now. Okay, so this is the website. We can see there are products, you can go and purchase them. Okay, and the range is from 3000 rupees to 70,000 rupees, the various products for these women. Now we are going to look at the Google Analytics of vary the website. I am getting. Okay, so here first thing we're going to check is the overview. Okay, so we're going to select the date range. Let's select from 1st January till 15th, 45 days period. Actually, when we do analysis, we check last 7 days, last 4 weeks, last 3 months, last 6 months, and last 1 year. So the ideal is one should look at the data points at various levels. So today I'm just showing purpose. I'm going to look at only 45 days, but when you do analyze, look at the data for various durations. Okay, I'm so sorry. I'm just checking if anybody. Yeah. So here you can see the sessions are 87,000. In last 45 day, users are 66,000, page views are 3.53 lakhs, pages per session are 4.05, average session is minutes, bounce rate is 53, and new sessions are almost 67%. Now, before we go into this analysis, we have to set some benchmarks. So the benchmarks are, for example, for a Sohanipetty website, or it's a jewelry website where there are 90% female population is coming and only 10% men population is coming. We have to set benchmarks as per the gender as well, as per their consumer behavior. So obviously, for the, like, if you're buying 500 rupee t-shirt, I will not check more than 4 to 5 designs. Again, that's my consumer behavior. But when it comes to jewelry, actually they want to any consumer would like to check at least 10 to 15 different designs. They want to see different patterns, so they like to go at least 10 to 15 pages. Compared to that, currently it is showing only 4.05. that means the ideal benchmark is 10 to 12 pages, but right now it's only 4.05. that means somewhere down the line we have to work on the engagement. Okay. I'm assuming if I'm not seeing the chat, so I'm assuming ki you guys are getting it. If any questions are, I just keep putting the chat so I will know what we are. Okay. So bounce rate is basically when someone come to a website and do not check any other page and close the website, that means we call it its bounce off. So in other language, when the page view is one, then we call it bounce, if the page bounce. So in case of e-commerce company, higher the bounce rate is bad. Ideally, it should be lesser than 30%. So the point I'm trying to make here is, for every parameter, we should have a different benchmarks. So keeping the benchmarks in tight. So for this website, the benchmarks should be at least 10 to 12 pages for page session. The bounce rate should be 30%, less than 30%. The average session duration, okay, must be at least more than 7 to 8 minutes to someone to buy. So right now the pages per session are only 2 minutes. Session duration is only 2 minutes. And the last parameter is new session. Can you see this? Green is returning users and the 67% is the new visitors. For any e-commerce company to grow faster, they must have more returning visitors than the new visitors. Why? Because when e-commerce companies they do marketing, for the first sale, most of them do the sale in losses. So to cover the losses, at least one person should buy from 3 to 4 times. So they will cover up the losses in long term. So when they build a strategy for e-commerce, they have to get one customer on the website at least 3 to 4 times to do a purchase. So the older the e-commerce website, the rating visitors should be more. Let me check. Yeah. Okay. So why the bounce is 30%? Again, there will be some bounce rate which you can avoid. So 30% is a tolerable limit, is an industry target, is an industry standard, you can say. Lesser the bounce rate is better. But unfortunately, there will be always some bounce rate. At least 20-25% bounce will be there for technology reasons, for various reasons. But at least try to make the bounce rate will be at least 25%. Now, you must have heard of remarketing. So e-commerce companies must use remarketing to increase this. So at least, so this Swani Petty website is 1 year old. So at least they should have 45% to 50% returning visitors. And when we are making strategy, we are putting more money or we are putting more focus to getting this green pie more. Okay, moving forward. Okay, moving forward. So I'm going to show you very, I will not show all the reports, but I'll show some key reports to you. So after overview, after knowing, so now the first conclusion of this analysis is, you know, e-commerce websites, this website is not meeting the basic benchmarks. Hence, we have to update the website. We have to redesign the website. We have to optimize the website. So it will meet the basic KRA. Now in the under audience, the second tab I want to show is behavior. Okay. Now you always check under behavior, check this tab, engagement. Now, there are e-commerce companies who try to show big numbers, big traffic numbers. So their first target is to get millions of traffic on the website. I am not convinced with the strategy, okay, because getting more traffic, but if they're spending lesser time on the website, the traffic is waste. So I'm in the favor, or I always suggest my clients, do not go after millions of traffic, but go after quality traffic. So even you get 10,000 traffic, that's okay. But if they're spending more time, so in this case, you can see there are 87,000 sessions, but 48, almost 50,000 sessions are ending in 10 seconds. Now that's not a good sign for an e-commerce website. I just said, to do a purchase, customer at least should spend more than 5 to 10 minutes. So if they're going in 10 seconds, that is not a good sign. So these are few things, you know, you have to check when you're analyzing the website, when you want to increase sales. So again, you have to use the football strategy. A goal will not happen until you meet certain criteria. So there are generally two criteria. One is the ball position. So in the football, they say, let's maintain 65% ball position and let's maintain 90% accuracy. If you meet these two criteria, goal will happen. In e-commerce as well, if you meet this 4 to 5 KRA, your sale will happen. If clients spend more than 5 minutes, if they check more than 12 pages, if the bounce is 30%, if they check more and more designs, sale will happen. So instead of worrying about sales, we have to work on each factor. So again, while working on 4 to 5 factors, at one time, work on 2 or 3 factors. So like say, work on the bounce rate first, then the obviously bounce rate, if you work on bounce rate, engagement will go high. Now there are few parameters to reduce the bounce rate. Okay. Now after, I want to show you technology. Okay. I will just quickly. Okay. Don't know charts. So I'm assuming it's going smoothly and you are understanding it. Okay. Yeah. So to check. So the first decision of a company is to change design. You know, design is not good, but that might not be true. Sometimes the simplest things can change the entire game. So I want to share one case study. I had one client, he opened his e-commerce website in USA, but he did the website designing in India to save the money by Indian developer. So I don't want to say anything negative about Indian developer, but there are certain habits. So clients spend 25 lakh rupees to generate traffic and he got very little sales. So he got worried. So when he came to me for my consultancy or for my suggestion, the first thing I check is the technology. Okay. So what had happened in the website, that since it was developed by Indian developer, he made the website in Chrome. He tested for Chrome. Whereas in USA, the Safari also have a very, very high usage. And the Indian developer did not factor that. He completely forgot, missed that point. So when they made the website, when they test the website, they test in Firefox and Chrome. And when we analyzed the website, we saw that more than 50% traffic is coming from Safari. And the website was not optimized. Website was not designed as per Safari. So when you make a website, you have to test the website at least on 10 different browsers. Most used browsers in your market. So again, in this case, as you can see, the Android WebView having the 42% traffic and having a bounce of 60%. So this gives indication that this website might not be doing well on the Android web view. On Chrome, Any questions so far? Any questions so far? Thanks. Okay. Thank you. Okay. So when you make an e-commerce website, the first thing you have to thoroughly check is the technology testing. So in generally in USA, Singapore, when they make the website, they spend 1 month only during testing. So they test the website at least on 10 different devices. They test the website at least 10 different browsers. So after doing the testing for thoroughly for at least 2-3 weeks or 4 weeks, then they launch the website. But somehow in India, people or the entrepreneurs or the founders, they do not have that patience. They want to launch the website immediately without testing. So when they launch the websites without thorough testing, they find there are so many bugs in the website. And worst case, they start spending money on it. So even though the traffic is coming on the website, they do not see the sales. Not because the product is bad, not because the idea is bad, but the technology is not ready. Just imagine somebody's opening a restaurant and spending crore rupees getting people in the restaurant. But in restaurant, the work is still going on. Okay, there are cockroaches running in the restaurant. Even after spending a lot of money, people are not going to eat in the restaurant. The first thing they should do is the proper set of restaurant before opening it. Same theory goes for these e-commerce websites or any online business. In 80% cases, the business is failing because their technologies wise, their product wise, they are not ready. So they did not open either mobile, they take a lot of time. If you want to buy, the payment mode is not active. So there are so many technical bugs. So one has to be very, very careful and take care of these technical bugs. Okay. So in this, it is very clear. So you can see overall, Android WebView and Android browser having the highest bounce rate. That means it's an indication that this website needs to be optimized on Android website or Android devices. Okay. This is one more. Mobile. Now in India, right now, 60% traffic to all websites or major websites is coming from mobiles. But when they think of design, they design the website for desktop and they make it responsive for mobiles. So they give priority to desktops. Whereas the traffic is coming from mobile. So there's an irony, but these developers, they do not understand the data. So since they have a habitual of designing the website for the desktops, they make it for desktops. Client also, when they check the websites, mostly on their desktops and laptops. So first thing, if when you see an e-commerce websites or any online business website, keep the laptop and desktop away. First, check the website thoroughly on your mobile. Again, 65% or 60% plus traffic is coming from mobile. Now in this case, you can see 76% traffic is coming from mobile. And it is indicative that mobile, it is not opening properly. So 67% traffic is not gonna give you the desired sales. Okay, so always look for this basic technology. Now again, I can show you which devices are coming. Always judge the traffic by this. So if you see a top phone, that means you can see the traffic is coming from a good quality phones. Okay. And in technology, I want to show you one more thing. Is screen resolution. It's very, very important. So when you design the website, take care of this screen. So 360 by 640 from this screen, 42% traffic is coming. And look at the bounce rate. Bounce rate is higher in this case. So it is very important to check the website in this particular screen and make sure the website looks and functions very efficiently in this particular screen. So just small pointers a website owner or a founder should take care of. But unfortunately, at least 40-50% of founders do not know what is Google Analytics, or they are not that well equipped with Google Analytics data points or numbers. And worst case, they do not even check Google Analytics. So the number one rule, if you ask me to make more profit from e-commerce company, have a separate data analysis team. But in most of the companies, they do not have the data analysis team separately. If someone gets time to do it, they do it. So data analysis is optional in our industry, can say. But for us, it is the most important factor. Okay, I'm moving ahead. So in audience, you obviously can check geology from which, but I will not show that, but again, which location they are looking. So if the location is, say, again, the location matters actually in case of jewelry. So if you go to north or south, depending on the weather, women choose the jewelry. So if very humid and hot, they like light jewelry. If women is cool or a little bit cool, they can go for big kind of jewelry. So you have to see from which location you're getting maximum traffic. And again, the style. I mean, the lifestyle of Mumbai and lifestyle of Chennai is different. So if you're getting maximum traffic in Mumbai, you can keep you can keep the jewelry as per that. So for example, here Mumbai, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai, or Mumbai, Bangalore, Hyderabad are the three cities we are getting top. But again, you can see there are different bounce rates. You can see different consumer behavior. You can see in Hyderabad, people are spending more than 4 minutes because Suhanipetty is Hyderabad base. Mumbai, they are spending one or less than 2 minutes. In Bangalore, they are spending more than 2 minutes. So even in the same website, the location-wise traffic matters. So you have to decide in which location you want to set up your business, and you have to provide products as per that location. Unless you are Flipkart or Amazon, who have a multi-products, okay? The other small players, they should adopt a location-based strategy. Yeah, Android is having the highest bounce rate because it looks like it is not optimized for that. And this is where we have come on the board, and we are telling the client, we are showing these data points to clients, and client is now optimizing the website in phases. So we have to use the different tools to do that. Okay. Okay, thank you. Okay. Now, I'll keep taking a chart after five minutes. So I know what kind of questions there are, or last 10 minutes I'll keep completely for the question answers. Okay, so now let me move a little faster. Okay. Now, after checking the audience, we have a saying that bounce is very high. Bounce is very high because it's not optimized for mobile. So, you know, when we do this analysis, we have to use 20-80% rule, where the assumption is 20% things will cover or control 80% of results. So when you analyze these reports, instead of going all the reports, you have to figure out those 20 reports or 27 reports which will give the maximum data points. So in last 10-15 minutes, we already know what is the problem. The problem looks like on the mobile devices, that to only Android devices. Obviously on Safari as well, it's on iPhone as well, it's high, but the major chunk is the major problem it looks like on Android. So when we do data analysis, we use the strategy used by doctors in emergency ward. So when the patient come to emergency ward, and if they have 100 wounds on their body, doctor will figure out which wound is bleeding high. And doctor will treat that wound or those wounds first. And they will ignore the small wound for some time till they work on the bigger wounds. Similarly, in Google Analytics, you have to work on bigger problem first. And if you start solving each and every problem, it will take years or months to solve that. So identify 4 to 5 big problems and sort them first, because those 4 to 5 problems is gonna solve your 80% of problems or the weightage of problems. So first problem is website not opening good on Android web views. Okay, now second, you can go to acquisition, okay, and look at all traffic source and medium. Okay, in this you will get a clear picture which traffic source is giving the highest results. So I am putting only goal right now. So goals are checkout page, goals are added to cart, goals are order success, the combined goals. So we can see from which source we are getting the, I'm just putting the laptop on charger. Okay. So Google Organic is giving the best results to Suhanibiti right now. Then the direct traffic and the Facebook, then the Bing Organic, Instagram, they are doing the Instagram campaign. So this data will show you which traffic source is giving the better results. So in some cases, some of the platforms, they do not give the results. So those platforms should be stopped and optimized. Again, this is not a one-time process. Every week, at least once, someone has to analyze these data points to take a right decision. Okay, then I want to go a little bit downer behavior. Okay, now always look. Okay, so we saw the people are leaving the website within 7 seconds. So let's figure out from which pages they are leaving. Okay, now if you go to casino or a big casino specifically, the moment you try to go out, someone will try to convince you to stay back. So they figure out from which doors people exit more, and they put the best people on those doors to keep people in the casino, because they know more time people spend in casino, they're gonna spend more. Similar in the website, you always have to identify from which page the maximum traffic is going out. So it looks like the home page is the page where the maximum people are going out. But wait, okay, I'm gonna put one more here. Let's look at the combination from which page they got in and they're going out. So they're coming in from, so landing page is the first page they land on the website. It can be home page, it can be inner pages, depending on the campaign you're running. So landing page is the home page, exit page is the home page. So it certainly gives a sense that there is some problem, or there might be some problem on the home page itself. So again, when you think of the whole website is not working out, again, you have to identify those 4 to 5 pages. So generally, clients think of changing the entire website. It's not required. You can just work on 4 to 5 pages, optimize those, and the whole website can work better. Okay. Now, landing page is this, experience is this. Okay. Now there is one more report in audience which says user flow. Now this is one of the important reports for me, and I like it. And I spend hours looking at these data points. I like just like to show you some of them. Okay. Cohort analysis is a very different topic at this moment, and it's in the beta version right now. So I need right now want to take you to a more important reports than, as I said, we have to look into more important reports. So there are more than 175 reports in Google Analytics, and actually we can we should at least look at 15-20 reports on a regular basis. I'm trying to show those 15-20 reports to you right now. Okay, now this is the user flow. So I want to explain in detail. I'll take a little more time for this, but this is very important. If you can see a little bit, okay, it shows the traffic flow. So I just want to freeze one. Okay, so traffic is coming from, so this you can select any, but I'm selecting the mobile, Facebook. So traffic is coming from Facebook. Okay, now how it's moving? The starting page is this. They're going to the shop women. Can you see the first interaction? They're going to shop women necklace. They're going shop women. They're going to, then they get closet. Okay, so they close it. Then they're going to shop women rings again. Earrings. So this is earrings. So they are going to this page, and after going to this page, then again look at this. So that landing from home page. So first is home page. They come into this page, okay, and again some of them are going to home page. Now this will happen for two reasons. First, if this page is not opening, or they did not find what they want to find on this page, so they're going back to home page. So as I said earlier, the problem might be on the home page, but wait, problem can be on this page itself, because people are coming from here and here and again going back. So problem can be on this page also. So one has to identify such pages and work on those pages and try to put more elements which will attract you. So you can check up to 12 interactions. Ideally, every week, brands or clients should analyze this at least for 7 to 8 hours. It will give us a lot of insights to the brands to look at, find the loopholes. But brands just believe in spending money. They want to spend money, and they want to keep getting traffic. But ideal ways to spend money, analyze, study, and then take next decisions. So any decision without data analysis might be a bad or incomplete decision. Okay, now, okay, so after behavior, I want to show you this one of the important report is the assisted conversions. Okay, I hope you guys watch football, and you must be knowing who is Messi. Obviously, most people know Messi because he does the final goal. But very few people know who passed the ball to Messi. So who are the midfielders? So if you remove those midfielders, Messi will be not that effective he is with them. So we have to find which are those mediums which are giving those assisted conversions. So let me give you example. When you do an email campaign and you see there is no sales, we think that email campaign did not work. Okay. So, but this happened, this generally happens. Like, see, I check the email in the mornings, I see something interesting, but at that moment I can't open it. So in the second half, I remember that, or maybe I see a Facebook campaign again. So the email campaign and Facebook campaign actually drive me to the go to the website and to the purchase. Now, what happens in this case, the all credit goes to the SEO or might be SEM campaign, because those did the direct goals, and people forget that I went to the website because I saw the email, because I saw a Facebook campaign. Because of these two campaigns assisted, this the Google happened. So before taking decision, always look at this chart, assisted convergence. So in this assisted convergence, it is showing, like, look at the Google organic, okay? There are two, assisted convergence and last click. It is very clearly shown that Google organic is doing lesser goals, but assisting in more goals. So when you take a decision, always look at these two numbers. Look at the contribution in direct and indirect goal as well. So I just said, if you remove those midfielders who are passing the ball to Messi, Messi will be not that effective. Okay, so no chart. So I'm assuming that you are getting my point. Okay. Now there is one more important data point, is a top conversion path. It shows the combination in which order client traveled to website. So in this case, they first found a website on Google Organic and they went direct. Okay. I want to show you some little longer paths. So all these reports are compulsory. Okay. Now in this case particularly, okay, people first interacted via Facebook, then they went to direct 3 times. Then they again saw the website on Facebook. Till this moment, they did not did any action. But after going through this, when the person came for 6 times, they did the goal. Okay. So who assisted the entire conversion is this campaign, this and this. Okay. Now I want to show a little bit different way. I think this is good. Okay, people come to see, you can see on this, they came direct 6 times. Then they saw ad on Facebook. Again, the people come direct 2 times. Then again, they saw on organic. And after looking at this for so many times, they finally did the, so there's a long path. And as I said before, the more time the customers will come back on a website, chances of your sale increases. So there's this report under behavior. New versus returning. Okay. You can clearly see returning visitors are only 28,000 sessions, but out of 629 goals, this 30% have finished 70% goals. So lesser the visits, but higher the actions. So when you get your customers back on the website, chances of them buying your product is high. So in e-commerce companies or e-commerce campaigns, remarketing strategy plays a very big role to sell the products. So if remarketing strategy is right, your sale will be good. Okay. Okay. How much time do I have? How much time I have? 15 minutes. I'm assuming 15 minutes. Okay. Now, So just a quick summary. In audience, I look at generally the behavior, technology, mobile, user flow, and the overview, these reports. Then I go to acquisition. In acquisition, I look at the social medium. Then I go to behavior. I look at the exit and landing pages. I need to know which pages people are leaving the website so I can work on those pages particularly. Then I need to know, I do analysis from which, what is the channel, which channel is giving the better sales, which combination of channels giving me better sales. And then I also look at the product performance, which products are selling more. On the other side, you can say gold tone rose wine earrings are selling more. So again, it gives the product wise data. So one has to analyze this data and do the purchasing and the selling as per this. Okay. Now I will open for questions. Please do ask questions. Please shoot your questions. Okay. Questions, please. So before moving ahead, questions. SEO Quake is the tool for the website SEO audit, but again it shows on the actual tool is a manual tool. So the any free tool, they just suggest the mechanical angle of the website, but the actual SEO audit done by the manual person. So the actual audit. Actual audit should be done by manual who understand or person who understand the website content, the website product, who has a market knowledge. So are the right kind of keywords are being used. So the any tool will just. Any tool will just show you the mechanical part of it. So I'll suggest go for a manual audit of the websites. Next question, please. No more questions. Can I continue? Okay. So, no. You just need to have one email ID. For each campaign, one email ID for all campaigns. So there is only one Google. There should be only one Google Analytics account per website. There should not be more than one email ID. Next question. Sorry. Any more questions? Shall I take another case study? Another website? Okay. So now there's one more website. Okay. Again, now we are going to put there's one more. Super And I'm showing the website which are in the development stage, so it's easier to understand. Okay. Again, this website into health products. They sell health products online. You can see the various products. Okay. Again, this website is in development. They sell fitness products. Okay. Now we are gonna see that as well. Again, I'll go a little faster. I'll just go and report by what I checked in the previous case. Again, I'm just taking 45 days data. Again, one person can take 45 days, 9 months, 1 year as per the duration of the campaign. Okay. I'll check the audience. Okay. Now you can see bounce rate is 67%. Okay. And the new session duration or the new sessions are only, returning visitors are only 13%. Now, this is not a healthy stat for any website, because if people are not coming back on an e-commerce website, that means you have to go after new, you can go after the new customers, which is costly. Going after new customers is always costly than going after the old customers, because old customers, you're at least halfway through. You don't have to convince from zero. But new customers, you're convinced from zero. Hence, you have to get more and more returning visitors to your website. Okay. Again, let's check the technology. So before getting into tech, logical or communication, always check the technology and make sure your technology is intact. Again, you can see the bounce rate is very high on this. Again, Chrome, Safari, UC browser is almost high everywhere. So this website needs optimization on all websites. Okay, let's look at screen resolution. Again, 360 by 64 is the leading resolution. Okay, now the data is less, so I am going, see, in this case, data is lesser, so I am going after at least 6 to 7 months back, and let's see. Yeah, from last 6 to 7 months, 360 by 64, 640 is the highest resolution. Again, look at the bounce rate is highest. Again, same, the developer should look into it. They should see which are the latest resolution, which are the latest phone being used, and they have to use that phones for testing of the website compulsorily. So what they do is they use the web-based tool, which are not those effective, because the actual mobile will show the website in a different way. So the tools they use for testing the websites are not accurate. Hence, the testing is not accurate. Hence, the results are not good. So in India, 80% startups are getting closed within 9 months of their operation. Not because their website, not because their idea is bad, not because their product is bad, because of they are not converting the traffic into sales. And what the biggest reason is, they try to save money on website development and they try to spend more money on marketing. Why clients infrastructure better? Buy good servers. Okay, so investing on technology always a good idea. Can you hear me now? I was saying the companies or the brand, they should also focus on technology of the website rather than spending money only on TV, print and the display campaign. They should spend good money Not yet. Wearable device in the, you mean watch? Not yet. Because for websites, if they open the app on that, it's different. But I'm not sure where it captures. So right now, there is nothing called smart watch as a device. They are showing as a mobile. They'll show as a mobile as of now, because we're using the usage of those such devices is very less. So there is no reports for wearable devices. It's a good question actually, but the usage is so low that there is no report for that. Okay. Again, let's say behavior engagement. I'll just go quickly. Oh, out of 5,600 users, 4,000 users left the website within 10 seconds. Now this is a big worry for this website. And again, we have told this client this about this, and they are now optimizing the websites. Okay. So this client wants to spend money on Google, but we said, hold your money, hold your campaign. First, work on the ground level. First, make the website better. Because even after spending money, they're going to come on this, and then there is no sale going to happen because of this website is not that user friendly. So again, we are going to improve that one. So again, look at this. Even though return visitors are only 13%, okay, 66% goals are coming from 13%. So we are gonna run their remarketing campaigns. So when people come back, they purchase more or they take more actions. So again, I'm repeating, e-commerce companies, they should have more than 50-60% traffic coming from remarketing in the second year. New website, it's okay. But if they're going to second year, they should have more returning visitors. Otherwise, they will not make money. And one of the reasons the even big agencies or big companies are in losses because they do not have enough returning users coming to your traffic and buy a website. So I'm going to ask, so which report should I go next now? Can someone answer? Which report should I go now? Which reports I should go in next? This is a question. Which report? Traffic source. Okay. 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 In this as well, Google Organic is giving them better results. And direct, then the Facebook campaign, they're doing it. Then they are doing Instagram campaign. They're getting traffic with Index. That's the other search engine. Okay. You can see more results. So one has to analyze these reports thoroughly. It is not 2 minutes job. One has to analyze, download, do some pivot tables, do VLOOKUPs, everything, and get the better numbers. Okay. Then I'm going into behavior. Again, let's try to find which pages people are exiting. Again, in this case, it's coming as a home page. Let me check which landing page they're going. Again, they're coming from landing page and going from landing page. Again, the same kind of behavior we're seeing. We'll try to find the user flow here. I'm going a little faster now because I have shown the video of repost to you now. So again, I'll go source and medium. And again, it is not necessary you have to also go the same reports I went. You can also check multiple reports, multiple things. Okay, this is what I do. So again, Google, again, people are coming for homepage. Again, you can see they are going from homepage to my account, shop, and again from that they come back to homepage. So generally, and now in this case, they're going to checkout page. That's a good sign. Okay. So in the fourth or fifth transaction or interaction, you should see maximum checkout pages. You can add, and keep analyzing. So to keep analyzing these reports and see which pages people are behaving weird, then I'll go conversions. I'll look at the product performance. Again, I'll analyze which product is giving maximum sales. In this case, our natural mineral water, super green organic frozen wheat. So I will analyze this and I will focus on these campaigns on these products. So I will focus my budgets on these products because these are selling. So I'll try to push the sale more. Then I'll go and look at the Monday. I'll try to find who are the Macy's and who are the assisted conversions. I hope you all seen the Chak De movie. You know, in one of the matches, that Punjabi girl plays the role of clearing the path of the forwards. So she does not do any goal, but she's equally important person because she clears the path for the forwards to go to goal. I hope all of you seen the Chak De movie. Okay, e-commerce sales is like that. Chak De strategy. In every match, Shah Rukh Khan implements different strategy depending on the opponent. So match against South Korea, different strategy. Argentina, different. England, different. Australia, different strategy. So in e-commerce companies as well, depending on situation, you have to implement different strategies. Okay. I think I have shown you both the case studies. Now I will take the final questions for next 10 minutes. How to open chat? Yeah, I'll take the final questions for the next 10 minutes. Any questions? Any questions? Yes, without testing. Was session helpful for you guys? Was it helpful for you guys? Okay. Thank you. So if no questions, can we? Thank you. Take it from the Karan sir, Rahul sir. Abul sir and Karan sir has my number. You can take it. So shall we sign out from this now? Okay, thank you.
Good evening, participants. I hope you enjoyed the session with Kamlesh, and I hope your queries are solved. And Kamlesh, it was a good session overall, and we enjoyed it with all your examples and all your explanation. You took it really good with all the questions as well. So it was a good session altogether. So that's it for today, guys. And if you want to watch it again or something like that, so we'll be uploading this recorded version on YouTube channel. So we'll share all the mails and all to all the participants. So you can check your videos on YouTube channel, okay? And do send us your comments, reviews on our Facebook page, and so that we can improve if in case we are lacking back with anything, okay? So have a good time, guys. Good evening, good night.
And thank you.
Take care.
Have a nice weekend.
Have a nice weekend, yes. Bye.
Bye.